Very good. All right, good evening again. Welcome to the birthday tribute and celebration for Nestor Torre's birthday. Tonight, we will hear friends, family, share and give their remembrances of our dear Nestor. As you know, this is part two of our honoring for our dear friend and love, beloved Nestor. And we thank everyone who agreed to be part of the program. Let us start with a prayer. Is everybody hearing me well? Okay naman, everything na. Okay. We'll start with a prayer. This was prepared by a dear friend of mine. She's from Tacloban, Sister Helen Makabingkel. And we've had the occasion to visit Tacloban with Nestor after Typhoon Haiyan. Nestor and I visited in October of 2014, but I was there before that. Nestor wanted to do a play on Pope Francis, inspired by the victims of Typhoon Haiyan. So I brought him with me in one of my trips there. And Sister Helen was one of the special people that he met. Sister Helen hosted us in her convent. It's a convent on top of the hill in Old Kawayan, Tacloban. And Sister Helen takes care of a poor community there. So she prepared this prayer to open our birthday celebration for N.U.T. with also a very special song from the children of Tacloban. So here, let me start with that. Start with a song first. So these children, well, like a few of these children also sang for him back then. This just the older one, I guess. But that was 7 years ago.
Thank you.
all know how much Nestor has a soft spot for children, so I think it's a very fitting way to open this honoring for him. So Sister Helen here will lead us in prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us now put ourselves in the presence of God. God of all goodness, we praise and thank you for gathering us together. And we glorify you for the great love you have for each one of us. Today, we remember in a special way our dear friend and brother, Nestor Torre. Thank you for the life and all the years he shared himself to all of us. We lift him up to you in honor of the goodness and the giftedness we witness in him. Look upon Nestor with tenderness and grant him the joy of the beatific vision of heaven. Bless each one of us with your grace, so that like him, we will be able to fulfill the mission you have entrusted to us here on earth, and continue to sow the seed of love to our least fortunate brothers, like what Nestor did. All this we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Okay, beautiful. So again, welcome to our Zoom celebration for Nestor. I'm Rose Cabrera. Well, I'm the de facto MC for today. I met Nestor 11 years ago, about 11 years ago. So I, compared to a lot of the people here, I'm like kind of very new friend of his. But as I said before, I think our friendship's kind of odd because we're very different. I'm not an artist, I'm not in theater, but we really bonded. And I feel I really shared a very special friendship with him. What bonded us was, of course, our love of theater and nation building. I am part of Gawad Kalinga and Geconomics. Geconomics is the social enterprise development partner of Gawad Kalinga. And Nestor was introduced to me by Celine Fabie of Ryan Kebyab Singers. Because we wanted to have a collaboration, maybe a GK musical or whatever. She introduced me to Nestor, and the rest is history. Somehow we clicked, and he actually mentored me to write a script for the GK musical that we wanted to come up with. And so like for many months, I would go to his house every week, and he would conduct one-on-one workshops with me. In fact, I'm very flattered because he said I'm the only one, the second one after Doy del Mundo, that he did a one-on-one writing workshop with. So I was like kind of, oh my God, you know, Doy del Mundo, the institution. And actually, Doy's here. Welcome, Doy, Kuya Doy. I was very happy that he really took the time. And I wondered why, because, you know, I'm not a professional writer. I'm not in theater. I just love what I'm doing. But he really felt, I guess, my deep passion for nation building. And he wanted me to harness that and put that in a creative way through a musical. And so what happened was we kept, so I did something, actually drafted something, which I really love. And I thought he would like it too. So it was entitled, Where in the World is Imelda's Shoe? Kasi it was inspired by, we had the Gawad Kalinga Hope Ball around that time at the Peninsula Manila. And Imelda Marcos donated a pair of shoes for auction, for the silent auction. So I thought I would write something about that. And my storyline was, one of our guests or attendees was a Marcos loyalist. Actually, the Marcos loyalist is from abroad. And she ended up sending her son to the ball to buy or to bid for that shoe. So so that was kind of the story. The shoe was bought, but then when it got to the buyer, it was only one pair. So the other pair was missing. So the story was about searching for the other shoe. And that search brought that guy all over the Philippines because he was following the GK volunteer who had the other shoe. I said the GK volunteer was traveling all over to the different communities from Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao. So, and then it turned into a love story because in the end, he fell in love with that. Anyway, so I was really in love with the story. And I wanted that to be the musical. Pero Nestor, well, Nestor liked the story, but he didn't like the title. He didn't want me to, well, his words more or less were, don't give her the parang the attention, no? Kasi nga, email, well, where in the world is Imelda Shoe? So, and I couldn't, I got stuck. I couldn't write another musical. Parang for me, this is it. So, parang kaming hard-headed. actually, I tried to write something else, but it never really got off the ground. And so anyway, that was it. So that's kind of one of my biggest regret is we never really pulled it off. We weren't able to produce that musical, the patriotic musical inspired by Gawad Kalinga. And largely because also of my hard-headedness. So now I'm in a dilemma if I should continue. I want to still do it someday, produce that musical. But I'm not sure if it should be my original idea or the new one that he also naman edited. I'm afraid if I do the first idea, baka magalit siya and atakin yung pa ako. So I don't know. I'm still praying about it. We'll see. Maybe it can be a combination of both. I'll compromise on the title. so there. So over the years, really, Nestor and I would travel he would give workshops to our GK communities, to our children. And that was very important because we wanted, you know, his dream was using the performing arts to uplift our people, to build our nation. He wanted to do like a radio broadcast of regular shows for the masses so that they can really appreciate art. So that brought him to Sulu, that brought him to Tacloban. We had a little side trip to Phuket. So, but it was fun. It's really a fun travel buddy. I really love him. I miss him, but I know that he's. Mitch Valdes, are you already? Okay, maybe we'll just start. Okay, Mitch was supposed to be the first one, but let's first, Mica, are you ready? Maybe let's start with the baby of Nestor. Actually, mother and daughter sila, no? And they have the same last name. I thought they were related. Hindi pala. They're not related, no? but I'd like to call on them. Mica.
Yes.
Mica is a protege of Nestor, no? Her first musical was when she was 5 years old. And it was Mga Birehen ng Kaisasay. We'll have the producer of that musical share later, Mr. Ramon Orlina. Wow, okay. But first, Mika will also share with us a song and then her mom will also share, Maria Cecilia Blanco Torre. So take it away, Mika.
Thank you po. Before I start, just a little background po. Hello po to everyone. It's so nice to see you. From the land down under. Very thankful na we can all be together to celebrate Derek's birthday po, even though we're so far away. This song, sigurado po ako alam nila kuya dyan to, tsaka nila tito rito, si Lola Andy. Ito pong song na to was one of the first songs that Derek has taught me during our one-on-one sessions. Ever since I was young, he was very supportive po talaga in terms of laging mag-practice. Pag-aralan mo tong kanta, then punta kayo sa bahay next week. Your workshop to. Syempre po, I was still very young. So mom and dad are the ones who does all that. Pero all I know is pupunta ako kay Direk, kailangan alam ko na yung kanta ko. Kailangan may idea ako ng blocking ko. Kung hindi, patay ako. It's either mapapauwi po kami o mapapagalitan ako. I don't think there was ever a workshop na hindi ako umiyak. Pero as I was sharing po with Tita Rose, yung feeling talaga na even though may takot ka na mapapagalitan, yung meron pa rin talagang love. Yung alam ko na, ay, may rehearsal kami ngayon. Very exciting. I get to see people. I get to learn. Tsaka po, he made me feel like this stage is my home. It's my playground. It's never half-hearted. Kaya po siguro talagang nakakatawa ng puso po na ma-share ko tong kanta na sa inyo. Hindi po ako pinakanta ni Direk ng kantang pang matanda. Bawal ng pang matanda. Pag nag-share kami ng lyrics na pang matanda, he'll say, no, ayoko niyan, pangit. And then he'll give a song that actually suits me na talaga pong matatandaan ko yung meaning tsaka makakanta ko ng maayos. Ito pong kanta na to, ang pangalan ay Ngumiti Tumawa. So, happy song. Sana po ma-enjoy niyo. Oh. Magandang gabi po. Ako po si Mica Torre. At ito po ang aking mga kaibigan. Si Mami, si Daddy, at saka po si Lolo Andy, si Kuya Jan, at si Tita Rito. Alam ko po na ang buhay ay medyo mahirap minsan, pero masarap din, hindi ba? Kung masama ang yung loob, mukha mo'y pumapangit kung ika'y magsimangot. Hindi lang ikaw ang may problema. Sino may gayon din, hindi ba? Iisipin mo ay yung iba ang pamilya ay maglo, may problema sa kwarta. Bawat tao'y may suliranin. Di lang ikaw iisipin, magpahinga muna sa problema ang dinadala. Kung very serious ka, baka naman mabuang ka. Ang tanging payo ko sa'yo, simulan mo sangiti at gaganda ang mundo. Mumiti, tumawa, magsayak, manta, loob mo'y gagaan. Pati ang problema, umiti, tumawa, magsayak, manta, gagaan pati ang problema. La 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 la. Kung very serious ka, baka naman mabuang ka. Ang tanging payo ko sa'yo, simulan mo sangiti at gaganda ang mundo. Ngumiti, tumawa, magsaya, kumanta, loob mo'y gagaan. Pati ang problema, ngumiti, tumawa, magsaya, kumanta, gagaan pati ang problema. La 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 la. Ang tanging payo ko sa'yo, simulan mo sangiti at gaganda ang mundo. Ngumiti, tumawa, magsaya, kumanta, loob mo'y gagaan. Pati ang problema, ngumiti, tumawa, magsaya, kumanta, gagaan. Pati ang problema. La 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 la.
soon, Nestor.
I competed with that song po sa Little Big Star. So yung po yung, I think that was my first song po on television. Dami pong workshop, daming workshop, pero naging worth it naman po by the end.
So yeah. Miko was 5 years old when she started, and now she's a teacher in Australia. Yes. Music, right? Music in a very prestigious school there, no?
Yes po.
Congratulations.
Thank you po. Yeah, just the love that he's shared.
Hello po.
Hello, Cecilia.
Hello po, Tita Rose. Salamat po sa part 2.
Yeah, maraming bitin eh. Yes.
Salamat po na naging part ng part 2 at salamat din sa kina Ate Isay. Medyo very emotional po ako kasi yung impact sa amin ni Direk parang kagaya sa iba. Lagi po akong naiiyak kasi iyakin talaga ako. Lahat po ng kasama dito, makaramihan po sa kasama sa part 2 ngayon na naka-online, kilalang-kilala po nila ako. Kasi kami po, tatagala naging family na kami sa theater group ni Direk. Kasi yung mga anak ko, kumakanta sila. Tapos kami naman ni Roy, syempre lagi kaming taong bayan. Yun lang po ang role namin. Kaya siguro na ni Direk na family parate, so hindi na siya mahirapan maghanap ng mga taong bayan kasama kami. Marami po akong karanasan kay Direk na talaga naman tinake namin positively. Mapapatunayan po yan ng mga katore namin na nandyan. Kami po ay cultured Torre. Very proud cultured Torre. Sina Jan Bo. Jan, wag kang matawa. Totoo naman, di ba? Andiyan sina Lea at saka si Tita Juju. Talagang in-embrace namin yon kasi kagaya nga ng sinabi ko, para ko siyang tatay. Alam mo, ang sasabihin niya lang sa pag meron kaming rehearsal, kasi alam niya, pag tatawagin niya lang ako, sabihin nasan si Cecil. Alam po ni Direk, alerto lahat ng pamilya ko. Sunod sasabihin niya, nasan si Roy. Si Roy po hindi to nagtitheater eh. Pero pag tinawag to ni Direk, lalabas to. Takot po kami lahat, pero masaya naman po kami. Kasi kasi hindi ko pwede hindi masaya, lagot ka. Iisipin mo for the love lahat yun. Meron mga pangyayari sa buhay ng tao na yung akala mo pinakataong hindi mo pwedeng malapitan, siya pa yung unang-unang magsasabi sa iyo na anong kailangan mo. Hindi po kami, simpleng pamilya lang po kami. Hindi ko po namin kilala si Direk na mag-audition kami sa mapagpalambirhe ng Kaysasay. Hindi namin kilala si Sir Ramon. Wala po kaming kilalang Odi Diaz, Isay Alvarez. Ang lahat po ng tao na yan ay siyang naging instrumento para po dito sa anak ko na to. Ito pong anak ko na to, kahit baligtad ang pantalon. Pag tinawag niya, nasan si Mica? Tumatakbo, nagkandahulog na ang salamin. Lalabas ha.
Curtain call, bukas yung zipper.
Kahit po, ganyan po kami. Pero lahat po ng pinagdaanan namin sa kanya, tinake po namin yan positively. Hanggang sa huling sandali, alam po yan ni Jamboy, si Kuya Rito, si Tita Lita, si Kuya Andy, sila po yung naging parte ng buhay namin. Ang pinakamalaki pong factor na iniwan sa amin ni Direk, paano kami maging mabuting tao. Yung buhay po namin ngayon, hindi namin ma-achieve kung hindi niya siguro kami bond as family. Na kung anong available, masaya kami. Kung hindi matching, magsusumikap kami. Hindi po niya kami pinabayaan. Yung mga birthday yan po, simpleng taon lang kami, pero sabi niya sa amin, pumunta kami. Kasi kakain kami. Kahit takot ako sa kanya, pagka naghuhugas si mami sa likod, pumupunta ako. Magliligpit ako, maghuhugas ako, pero sabi lagi ng mami sa likod, ni Uwa, si sir. Ibig po sabihin, bawal lang maingay pag naguhugas ka. Kasi maririnig. Diyan. Tawa ka na. Kasi madidinig po ni Sir Don. Nagpapasalamat po ako sa lahat ng tao na naging bahagi ng ng kung nasaan po kami ngayon. Hindi po namin kung hindi po namin yung pagiging masikap namin. Tsaka prayerful po. Salamat po sa inyo lahat. And salamat pong nakita ko ulit kayo, mga minamahal.
Thank you po. Thank you, Cecilia. Thank you, Mica. Good to share from down under, no? And now let's get our sharer from Manila. Photo finish siya. Thank you very much for joining. She's one of the first ones to confirm part of this, and we're very glad. Really, she's one of the best things also of Nestor to me. Nestor introduced her to me. I think was with that 7 years ago, and she did some projects for us with Gawad Kalingan Economics and Mabuhay Rest Up. May I call on our very dear Mitch Valdes?
Hi. Hello, everyone, friends of Nestor. I'm so glad to see all of you. I'm sorry I have no pictures to share because
I have.
I'm not until Facebook came along. I never saved my own pictures. Nahihiya ako pag ano. I'm not the type na going back to the memories because I have the memories in my mind. They're, you know, when I think when you're a performer, you share in your heart. Ayan na.
Ayan. Oh.
Ayan. No, you know why? Just to explain this picture. Nestor is the person in my life na for me kasi I am just so, my world is all the entertainment, the arts, the everything. And then I'm the type kasi who shuts down and everything is finished, then I go recharge. So Nestor is the link and was the link to people like Rose and all the other events in my life that had, I didn't ever think I was going. You know, like for example, he called me for this to sing in the middle of a environmental beautiful awareness for all these fantastic youth who came to the Philippines and had a solution to all the poverty, the criminality and everything, make them productive, turn them to agriculture, turn them to everything, and this was it. So I would never have entered that if it weren't for Nestor. And of course, di ba, when Nestor calls.
I can't see you.
So that is one. Another one is Nestor connected me to a Holy Land pilgrimage. Can you imagine that? Pumunta ako sa Bethlehem, sa the place of birth ni Jesus Christ, sa manger, me. So then Nestor is the link to all of this outside of theater. Sino ba naman akalain kakanta ako dyan sa gitna ng isang ecology village ng Pilipinas na ang init. Alam mo naman si Nestor, pag mainit at gutom, masungit. Sungit niya! pag hindi nasusunod yung kanyang vision at may mga inept na mga tao, record, sakit, ano. But, I think, maybe aside from Ramon Orlina here and Rito Asilo, Nestor was a part of my life already in the late 60s through Repertory Philippines. Kasi siya yung nag-introduce sa akin ng aspect na doon siya nakilala nandun na mga Zineida Amador, nandun na yung mga theatric, theater icons. No? So, he was always there. I was just a stagehand in repertory. And then, I think, nahalata nila ni Bibo na actually, ang gusto ko hindi stagehand. Ang gusto ko ay mag-perform. So he was there. He was a constant. He was there in all my concerts because syempre, you call him up to review. And as Celeste Legaspi said, when Nestor Torre gives a positive review, assured na yung ticket sales no, because they use him as a reference point whether a concert or a theatrical production is worth going to. And of course, he will not spare any criticism, but it's very valuable. So you don't take it as criticism.
Again? Oo.
So that was Nestor. And common denominator, we love to eat. We love to drink alcohol. And he understands artists. He has no patience for people who does not understand the process of creativity. And what else? So I would like to thank Nestor Torre, who was part of my life ever since I was 15 years old, and who you unconsciously revert to for comments about what you are doing, because you're risking by his attending your concert, you are risking the opinion of this masterclass artist, and he will make it public, di ba? Ilalagay niya sa pinaka na one of the valuable columnists of Inquirer. So, pero alam ko naman na yung mga commentaries niya are not going to turn away ticket buyers. His heart is so into loving the performer and the performance and the author of whatever creative output is there. So even with performing in the noontime heat with Rose and Nestor in a hillside in Bulacan, but you should have seen the beautiful projects that he was able to usher in together with the group. So I personally would like to thank Nestor Torre for enriching my artistry and improving my perception of what other people do. Because without him, I would have not ventured too much outside of the performing industry. So thank you very much, Nestor. You know that we love you. We appreciate you. And you have so many, many artists that he is not publicly acknowledged for all the good works. Do you realize that, guys, na sa lahat tayo dito na may ginawang maganda, hindi siya yung nauuna sa self-marketing. So it is really a generous heart because... Hi, Arlina! She's the one who brought me to the Holy Land!
Huh? I was just messaging her eh. Baka you can also share about that, Arlina.
I will leave that to Arlina and I will leave this... beautiful environmental development project and people development project to Rose. But I just wanted to tell you that this is the Nestor that we experience outside of the world of our own creative endeavors. And he really encourages good works. You know, he really encourages it. Now that Arlina is here, I have to tell you that Nestor is the type of person, when we were in the Holy Land, three buses of pilgrims, and I got so sick because I had to sing in the open air. I didn't know it was 8-10 degrees. But can you imagine, Arlina and Nestor entrusted me to entertain the the Jerusalem
Bethlehem
and the Palestinians. Can you imagine? I performed actually in Bethlehem, di ba? Nasa loob pala ng Palestine. You know, may barbed wire. Lahat may
Palestine.
May sniper, may lahat yung ganon. So, without Nestor, I would never have, siya yung laging middleman ng mga wonderful projects na out, na kasama yung performances, pero linalabas niya beyond our enclosed perception. So that is Nestor. The Palestinian mayor or something wanted to transfer us kasi there was a threat of bad weather. He wanted to transfer us to sing, to perform na lang in, ano, in a restaurant that he owned. Sabi, sa loob ko, I did not come all the way to Jerusalem to perform in a restaurant. I went there. Hindi ko sinabi yun, Arlina. What does the weather report on social media say? He looked at his phone. You know, tulsa ko pa yung mayor. Sabi niya, oh, it's Sunday tomorrow. Therefore, we sing there in the manger. So, and then while everybody else was still having dinner, I got called to go backstage already on Christmas Eve. And so without taking my dinner, syempre performer, di ba? I had to run with the Palestinian soldiers to the manger. And then, my goodness, Nestor left the dinner. And he followed after 30 minutes. Sabi ko, what are you doing here? Kasi mag-isa ako nakagalugod sa likod ng stage. Tapos, dumating si Nestor alone, walking uphill, just to sit with me. Can you imagine? And we didn't even talk, you know. His presence, you know that he was trying to take care of you. And he did not eat his wonderful Palestinian dinner. I would have gone. How interesting. That was the nice part of that trip also. And of course, my goodness, going to the pilgrimage, my goodness. So anyway, I'd like to thank Arlina for that. And I'd like to thank Nestor for that. And I'd like to thank all of you who have wonderful memories to share. I understand now there are so many other speakers here, but that is, and also, of course, Katie, yung wonderful, wonderful, magagalit si Celeste, Katie with an exclamation point. There's that song there kasi na we developed it from raw material to how it evolved in Rizal Theater to how it was able to transfer in the cultural center. So there's a song there that became like the ballad of performers. And I would like to leave you with the refrain. Ang lingap mo'y hahanap-hanapin sa entablado minsan ay sa akin. At kung ako ay malimutan kahit sa awit, kuman lamang iyo sanang matandaan bago tuluyan. Lumisan na minsan ang minahal ay ako. Thank you, Nestor.
Yay. Oh, wow. Thank you very much, Mitch. That was beautiful. Oh.
I see two Rose and Anna. What is she? Rose and Arlina.
Oh. Arlina, yes. Would you like to add to that? Hi, yeah.
Hi, do you hear me?
Yes, the travel buddy of Nestor, right?
Yeah. You know, I wanted to share that the first time I had the invitation from our tour operator in the Holy Land to bring along a singer, the first person I approached was Nestor. I asked Nestor, who would you recommend? Without batting an eyelash and without, you know, he said, Mitch Valdes. Oh, ganyan siya, top of the mind. And on that trip, I think we had Ramon Orlina and his family also with us, right, Mitch? Yeah, Ramon, yeah. It was really fun, you know. We had a lot of good friends there, and I brought my whole family also, and the children were all, you know, friends with all the other children of the parents who were with us. So it was really fun. I know I have a video of that, but right now I can't find it. I asked my son, but he's not replying to me. I would have loved to show Mitch singing there. Maybe later, if my son joins in, he might be able to put in at the end.
OMG.
Okay.
Galeng, Mitch, we're so proud of you. Grabe.
Take two again.
Guwapo ng mayor, incidentally.
Yeah, his name is Maher Kanabati. You remember?
Guwapo.
Yo, guwapo.
Nag-interesan pa yung Palestinian mayor.
Thank you, Arlina.
Thank you.
You mentioned our next chairer. We'd like to call on him. Again, he was actually the first one who confirmed to be part of this. So thank you very much. Ramon Orlina, our, yes, great artist, national artist. Hi, Ramon.
Okay. Hello. Nice meeting you again with the people here. Nandiyan pala si Rito. Tsaka, yeah.
Sila Andy, yes.
Si Andy, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
By the way, Tommy Abuel wanted to join. Kaya lang,
the downstairs is really
technically empty. Challenged daw eh. So.
Non-event tables, no?
Yeah. I remember this,
Ayan na.
Yan.
So you produced a Birhen ng Kaisasay, right? Was that?
Yeah, I produced the Birhen ng Kaisasay. Yeah. No. So.
Tell us how that came about.
Yeah, I'm a devotee of the Birhen ng Kaisasay since 1924, no? And I had this great idea to make a musical, no, in her honor. And my mom tried to do something about it in 1982, but did not happen. It's too difficult. So I had an appointment with Tata Nanding Joseph of SCCP, this is the district director, and I said, can you help me on this, no? And he said, oh, I can recommend you if you want somebody to write about it. You see, better write, talk to Nestor Torre. And good thing is, when we talked to him, he was so happy about it and agreed immediately, you know, without hesitation. Hence, from that point, the new musical, mapaglamalang Birhen ng Kaisasay. No, and the music, no, was composed by none other than the national artist Ryan Kayabyab, no, with the power half of cast na playing high bing is si Cocoy Laurel, si Ogie Alcacid, other distinguished members, including Abby Violan, Tommy Abuel, Andy Baez, Rito Asilo, Lou Beloso, Albert Jimenez, of course, the Torre family, Nicole David, and Ira Marasigan, who became my friends for life. including also the si Cheloy Dance, who was part of the play. You know. The theater art performance is new to me, and then it was good that Nestor Torre guided me on every step on the way. He recommended to me the musical director, the arranger, the costume designer, actor, director that needed to make my dreams come true. There's the picture of Tata Nanding, no? And she was the one who told me that I get Nestor Torre, you know, and without hesitation, he said yes, no? So really it's something that that practice that you can see at the sala was my living room, no? I would take up all the living room, the dining room, and the, you know, parang yun aking doon mag-rehearsal, no? So, yeah, this is yung aming, meron kaming birhen kay sala nila na yung during the time na meron. Andang dito. Performance ano yung ano ba yun yung merong no merong parada ng mga birhen, there are procession ng mga birhen, December 8, no, and Nestor and
Grand Marian procession,
the Grand Marian procession was I'm part of it, sumasali ako. Ang birhen kay Sasay, sinasali ko every year. No? Itong last sila, hindi natuloy dahil na nagkamiroon na ng problema dito sa COVID. No? So, yan. So, parang one big family kami dyan. Talagang si Nestor Torre is ibang klase. Pero iba yung passion talaga ni Nestor. I can tell you that she's a theater. I was swept into the different world of amazing of this theater art, you know. I always be grateful to Nestor for he has supported me all throughout, you know. He continued to support me in all areas of my life. Even during my work as a sculptor, when I make my museum in Tagaytay, my family, he would never fail to write about me and my endeavors in the daily choir. Always with such glowing terms, Leon and I would so much thank him. Also miss Mommy Bliss. Right now, they are reunited in heaven. We shall cherish the memories of them in our hearts. Nestor, your legacy lives on your creative works, where our enrich us to know that you and you have celebrate us with your life. You celebrate your life. Thank you for your. Thank you for you celebrate your life. Thank you. Yeah, well, wala ako sa kwento. So, yun.
Yeah.
Would like to celebrate the gift of you for us. Thank you very much for being here with us during that time. But now, we would like to greet you. Happy birthday in heaven, rest in peace, dear Nestor. We love you and we'll always be part of your memories. Thank you very much. And to all, thank you very much, Nestor. May you rest in peace.
Thank you, Ramon. I remember seeing so many Ramon Orlina's sculptures in Nestor's home. So I know he really appreciated working with you, and that Birhen ng Kaisasa is really very close to his heart, being also a Marian devotee and all. I was born December 8 too, so I wish I can watch again Birhen ng Kaisasa someday.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. May we now call on theater friends also of Nestor. They go back a long way. Raymund Marcaida and Rosana Robles. Raymund, are you there? Let's see. He said he's here. Raymund. Okay. Rosana?
Yes, I'm here. I'm here.
Hi.
Yes. Hi. Yes. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for having me. I would just like to say a short story about how I met the great Nestor Torre, who gave me, who boosted my morale. It was, I just started singing at that time, and I was singing in a lounge in one of the hotels with a pianist, I was singing solo. And I think he was there waiting for, he was going to watch a show somewhere in that hotel, but he was early. So he sat down at the lounge. And I didn't know him. I mean, he didn't know me. I didn't know him personally. But I knew who Nestor Torre was. Lo and behold, I don't know how long after, I suddenly saw a write-up on his column in Inquirer saying that I was very underrated as a singer. Can you imagine how I felt, you know, from Nestor Torre saying that? So I know that he's not someone who, well, sorry to say, di ba, others in the media, in the press, kailangan, ilabas mo, kailangan, alam mo na. But he didn't even know me, you know? So parang, wow, talagang heartfelt. So I wrote to him, I sent him card thanking him for what he did for me. And then I had the privilege of working with him in a musical when they first brought the snow here in, I think that was SM North, that was December 1990 to January 1991. We would perform every night at SM North. And I felt I was very privileged to be able to work with the great Nestor Torre. So I just want to say that he's such a kind and generous heart. And we wanted, when I found out he was sick, I called and I was able to talk to his nurse at the time, Angie. We wanted to visit him in Marikina when he was there in December, before December 2019. But then Angie got back to me and said, he's not ready. So in September of 2020, I again talked to Angie, and she told me that Ness was better. You know, he's home in Santa Ana. Pero yun na nga, pandemic na. So we couldn't visit him. Raymund and I were planning to visit him because Raymund and I were together in that musical. So yun na nga, I was so shocked when I learned that he passed on last month. I was so surprised because they said he was better. so it's really so sad to lose someone with such a kind heart. Pero stricto, di ba? Pero, you know, totoong tao. That's all I can say. Thank you, Nestor. Happy birthday. Totoong tao ka, and I will never, never forget you. That's one thing na for someone who was singing bagong-bago pa lang in the 80s, ang laking inspiration ang binigay niya sa akin. So again, thank you very much. It was my honor to have met you and to have worked with you.
Mm-mm. Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much, Rosana. How beautiful talaga how Nestor finds a treasure in us, no?
Yes, yes, that's true. Mm-mm.
Let's, yes, Mitch, yes. Oh, unmute, Mitch, unmute. There you go.
Yeah, tanong ko lang, bakit hindi ka na nagsisimba sa Mary the Queen, Rosana? Hindi na kita
nakasimba. Paano? Paano nga pandemic, di na tayo. Nung November up to January, bago lumabas yung mga bagong...
Distancing na, ha? Magsimba ka na?
Hindi nga. May distancing na noon, kaya lang natatak. Hindi mo ba alam, mga madre sa Ika at saka yung sa Savior, may COVID? Di ba? Nasa ospital yung mga madre, kaya takot ako. Online na lang ako everyday.
At least miss ko lang yun.
Yeah. Nice seeing you, Mitch.
Nice seeing you.
Okay, thank you. Now let's switch gears. Let me play this song. This is from one of the GK performing arts groups that Nestor had also helped and gave workshops to. This is the Mabuhay Choir. They're from GK Tatalon in Quezon City. And they prepared this song. They chose this song kasi daw Nestor made them believe. Okay, let me share that. Is Glenn here? There you go. Yeah. So he wrote this. He was worried that his grammar was wrong, but I guess it's not here. I'll just read it. So we were originally brought together for artistic purposes. Then we soon began to learn from his views and perspectives and his wealth of knowledge. We never met someone as equally impressive, smart, and grounded as Direct Nut. You'll be forever in our hearts.
Many nights we pray with no proof anyone could hear. In our hearts awful song we barely understood. No, we are not afraid. Oh, no, we know there's much to fear. We were moving mountains slow before we knew we could. There can be people cause when you believe. No hope is rare, it's hard to keep. Who knows what people cause you can achieve. When you believe, somehow you leave. You will when you believe. In this time of fear, when prayer's soft and proven pain, hope seems like the summer birds deceitfully run away. Yet now I'm standing here, with heart so full I can't explain, speaking faith and speaking words I never thought I'd say. Oh, they can be miracles when you believe. The hope is rare, it's hard to keep.
to give. Who knows what miracles here can achieve, in you believe. Somehow you're real, now you're real. You will when you believe.
The Mabuhay Choir. Yeah. Can remember they're always afraid when Nestor comes along because usually, you know how exacting he is. And I remember when we had our audition for Manila Vanilla and we were developing the GK Performing Arts Group, Nestor told me, I told him, let's cast naman some of our GK performing artists in our musical, you know, at Mabuhay Rest Stop in Luneta. And he said, typical Nestor, I'm not gonna get them just because they're GK. So which is true naman, syempre, that's really what we want to develop in our artists, no? Talagang that standard of excellence. And so here we have to share with us one of our GK performing artists. He actually went to school and graduated at Mint College in theater arts. And a largely because also of Nestor's influence. Felix, are you there, Felix? He is from GK Gawad Kalinga Baseco. He did send his video. Let me just play it kasi baka yung signal niya is not good. Hold on. Here. So now Felix, Felix is one of the folk dancers in our Manila Vanilla show.
Hello, magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. My name is Felix Tiongson.
Oh, wait, is it
screaming? Gusto ko lamang pong sabihin kay Direct Nestor
sorry.
Na maraming salamat.
Okay. There you go. Screen share. Okay.
Hello, magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. My name is Felix Tiongson po. Gusto ko lamang pong sabihin kay Direct Nestor na maraming salamat dahil naging director kita sa isang show. Maraming salamat dahil nakatrabaho kita. Maraming salamat dahil isa ka sa mga dahilan kung bakit ako naging strong performer nung mga time na yon. Kasi naalala ko na pinagalitan mo ko at sinabihan mo ko na ridiculous. Ayun. Siyempre, napahiya ako noon. Nahiya ako sa mga kasama ko sa stage noon. Pero inisip ko na lang ay gawin ko tong motivation para maging magaling, maging strong, maging performer. Hindi ko inaasahan yung pagkawala ng director kasi nga matagal na ang panahon na hindi ko siya nakikita. Nakakalungkot isipin na hanggang doon na lang yung mag-share ng talent. Hanggang doon na lang yung ma-share wisdom sa mga performer. Kasi sobrang galing yung director ni Nestor. Pero naging masaya ako at nagpapasalamat dahil binigyan mo ako ng pagkakataon na makatrabaho ka. Binigyan mo ako ng pagkakataon na mag-grow as a performer. Kaya naman nagpapasalamat ako kay Direct Nestor Torre.
there. Thank you, Felix. Felix really has been a pride and joy of our Economics Performing Arts Group. And it was really largely because of Nestor Torre that we were able to develop that, because we want our disadvantaged communities to really appreciate the arts and to have performing artists from among them to share their stories. So hopefully we can continue Nestor's legacy. The work also brought us all the way to Sulu. Would you believe that was in 2011? We have here a sharing by Jainab Abdulmajid. She's a friend of ours. She's the head of Gawad Kalinga in Sulu. And she took the time to also record this honoring for Direk. Let me share this with you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. I want to give a brief tribute to the late Nestor Torre, a good friend of J.K. Norris, who bravely went to Sulu to visit the Tausugs in Sulu. Kasama na ako doon. Of course, hindi ako nag-expect na isang Nestor Torre ay pupunta sa Sulu para malaman yung kondisyon ng mga Tausugs sa Sulu, lalo-lalo na yung mga family sa Gawad Kalinga Village. Marami siyang mga tinanong noon sa akin at sa mga pamilya sa Gawad Kalinga. Nagtanong siya about sa kultura ng mga Tausugs. Nagtanong din siya about sa condition ng mga family sa Gawad Kalinga. At nag-explore siya paano siya makatulong through Gawad Kalinga. Yung pagpunta niya sa Sulu is a sign that he is very concerned his Muslim brothers and sisters in Sulu. And kung siguro buhay pa siya hanggang ngayon, siguro makikita namin yung tulong niya sa mga Tausug sa Sulu through Gawad Kalinga. But nevertheless, malaking bagay yung pagpunta niya sa Sulu dahil he crossed the boundaries. Hindi niya inisip na nakakatapos ang Sulu. Subalit, pumunta siya personally kasama yung J.K. So, doon ako nagpasalamat kay Nestor U Torre. May his soul rest in eternal peace. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Jainab. I remember our trip there. Well, of course, Nestor enjoyed the crabs. But it was very memorable talaga. And I really thank God for that experience. Moving on, we want to share with you this video honoring also of Ms. Cheche Lazaro. So I discovered something new about Nestor from Cheche's sharing here. I'll be stopping on the, okay.
I joined the many friends and the family, and
thank you. Tita Rose, I think everyone can hear the audio. Oh.
He was good at his craft because he was a very the humanity of Nestor, his kindness. He was always soft-spoken and very gentle, but you knew that he was good at his craft because he was a very giving and generous person, generous in his heart and generous in sharing what he knew. So to you, Nestor, we remember you with fondness. God bless you and Godspeed.
Were you able to hear the full video? Sorry, Mica. Okay naman. Ano? The audio conked out near the start, Tita Rose. Oh my God, sorry ha. Ano ba yan? Oh, sorry. Okay, let me just, it's short lang naman. Let me just play it. Hi. Okay. Attention na, I'm new at this. Okay, share screen. Take two.
I join the many friends and family and admirers of Nestor to remember him on his 79th birthday today. I first met Nestor way back in 1964 when I was a new student at the UP. He was my teacher in the Department of Speech and Drama. But aside from that, Nestor, who's a multi-talented actor, director, writer, and media colleague in later years. Nestor was also a dancer. I'm sure many of you are not familiar with
Negro his dance pelo.
But when we met in 1964, we were both invited by the College of Music in UP to join an operetta they were mounting called The Unicorn by Giancarlo Menotti, and it was to be directed and choreographed by Rolando Tino, another great in the entertainment industry. And both of us were working together with Rolando, on that operetta. It was a medieval setting, and we were in what I considered medieval costumes, but it was a great experience. And there you found the humanity of Nestor, his kindness. He was always soft-spoken and very gentle, but you knew that he was good at his craft because he was a very giving and generous person, generous in his heart and generous in sharing what he knew. So to you, Nestor, we remember you with fondness. God bless you and Godspeed.
Thank you. That was really a last minute addition to our honorings. I really thank Ms. Cheche Lazaro for coming through. Now I'd like to call on, we're down to our final two sharers. Is a cousin of Nestor here, Ametta Taguchi? Ametta? Jurosi, do you know if she's here? Okay, maybe.
She's Mila. There. She's just trying to unmute herself, Tita Rose.
Okay.
Yes. I'm Ametta. I'm in Cagayan de Oro. And of course, Nestor is from Cagayan de Oro. Now, I would like to share something that is not very much known because we all know about his greatness as being a writer and all that. So I wrote it down because Tito would always say to me, please write down, if you cannot speak extemporaneously, please write down what you want to say so that you will not go around and around and around. So here it is. Nestor was Tito to his parents. Not we, his parents called him Tito. And to us cousins. And his nephews and nieces, of course, call him Tito Tito. And when he was a kid, his mom would call him Otit whenever he misbehaved, when he was contrary. His mother, Isabel, or Tita Blit, was the sister of my mother. So Tita Blit was like a second mother to me. And all of us in the family were very close to Tita Blip. But when it came to Tito, we had a deferential attitude towards him because of his legend. You know, as a student, his IQ was measured and it was superior, touching genius. Now, so that alone would scare us. And then he could write a 2-page essay by hand in 20 minutes without erasures or revisions. And he was a portrait painter. He won all the debates and elocution contests, acting, writing contests in school. I could go on, but we know all about it already. In short, he was a model student and son. He was perfect. And we were not, we were the opposite of perfect, not the cousins. We're naughty and lazy, and a joker, happy-go-lucky, and then he was very serious. And the other reason why we tiptoed in Tito's presence was he had a very tough and cold exterior. We all know that. Now, for example, you would ask him a question about himself. He would give one-word answers like yes, no, right, maybe, like that, no? He was a very difficult person to interview, like Eddie Garcia, I heard. Now, I remember a story he shared later when we got close about an experience he had as a Rotary exchange student in the USA. The family that adopted him for a year had the same comment that Tito had perfect manners, perfect behavior. He was very popular in the public speaking circuit that was part of his exchange program. And he had many fans. His Barong Tagalog, he brought several. When he came back to the Philippines, they had tears, no? Because his fans would hold on to him and grab him and kiss him and all that. But he was cold. He seemed not to want to connect. So one day, his American Rotary mother took him for a joyride, hoping the trip would start a thawing of the ice. But nothing happened. Tito's side of the conversation was all yes, no, right, maybe, thank you, good, that's great. Nothing personal. So the Rotary mother suddenly stopped the car and she began to scream, as in really scream, as in scream. And she was shouting and she was screaming, why are you so cold? I am doing everything to know you, to be your friend. What is it that I must do to reach you? And this was a turning point for Tito. After a long silence, he answered, I don't know why I am like this. Even as a child, I kept to my center. Then he related and even wrote about it later, how as a grade one student, he was so cute that his teacher adored him. Math was not Tito's forte, so the teacher told Tito's mother, my aunt Tita Blit, about it. Mom, she said, what will I do to your son? And Tita Blit, Tito's mother, answered, fail him. And the teacher said, I cannot. He is so cute. And so one day, there was a math test, and Tito's paper was blank because he did not know the answers. So the teacher looked around, and then she slipped the answers, and then she walked away. When she came back, Tito's paper was still blank. So the teacher whispered, why did you not copy the answers? And Tito said, Mom, it is wrong to cheat. And the teacher screamed. She went wild. There was something wrong with her. And Tito must have been so traumatized because he could not remember what happened next. This sharing saw the eyes between him and the Rotary mother when he told her this story, you know, and then they slowly connected. And he also began to wonder why he was like this. For me, the thawing of the eyes happened when I joined Tito's script writing workshop. This has been said before, but I would like to say it again. He was the best teacher we in the workshop ever had. Other workshops talk about playwriting, just talk, that's all. But in Tito's workshops, plays got written. And others won Palanca Awards and other awards. So as a result of our common love for the theater, Tito and I began to have warm conversations. And they were all related to playwriting, play production, and what exactly I wanted to do with myself. I realized he was not the sort to engage in fruitless chit-chat. He appeared cold on the outside, but deep down, he really cared for people without being showy about it. Like, for example, sending me a big amount of money through the bank from Manila to Cagayan de Oro to buy briefs and panties for the victims of the flood, Sendong, here in Cagayan de Oro. Because this was a need that was not filled. I told him about it, no, that the people were crying out for panties and briefs. And so he sent the money. But Tito sternly told me, don't tell anybody about this, okay? Well, sorry, I am talking about it now to show Tito that you never wanted to draw attention to yourself. And so, as you can tell, he was warm and soft under his iron armor. Tito was a do person when a problem appeared. You know, you did not have to tell him there's a problem. He had a sensitive radar for that. And he dropped his armor at once to do something to alleviate the problem. You could not fool him. That was when his sensitive part would come out. He could read you. If you were pretentious, he liked people who were simple and honest and funny. He didn't like put on people. So I could not fool him either. He could read me, no, without he just knew me. In one conversation, he said, "You know, Ametta, you will never be happy until you begin liking yourself and accepting yourself. Stop pretending to be what you are not." It was a turning point for me. So Tito, I will never forget your workshops, the fun we had doing plays in Cagayan de Oro. It was very funny. Stories that we experienced, how you made me translate to Cebuano the unrhymed lyrics of Magnificat, how you made me translate Portuguese to Cebuano, even though I don't know Portuguese. Translate, you made me translate Maranao and Tausug to Cebuano, even if I don't know Tausug and Maranao. You made me do a lot of impossible things, and in so doing, you took me out of my shell of defeatism. So, thank you for being you, Tito. Happy birthday in heaven. And please embrace Tita Blit for me. That's another person I would like to talk about. And please tell Tita Blit that I'm actually writing a book about our family and about our family tree. And so thank you for giving me this chance to talk about this very, very wonderful cousin.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Ametta. That was beautiful. Oh, well. Anyway, let's call now on our new, another sharer. He got disconnected earlier. Raymond? Raymond, are you there?
Magandang gabi sa lahat. I'm Raymond Marcaida. I met Nestor when I was 27 years old. And I'm now 59. So that was like 32 years ago. I was a student dancer then, and my first encounter with him was with the musical KP in 1988 with Mitch Valdes as the lead. So I was a dancer then, and what I learned from Nestor is he always pushed me to do new things. Like I was a dancer and then he pushed me to be part of the cast. Then later on, he pushed me to be a choreographer. He dragged me along in other productions, and he pushed me to become a stage manager and do different things, you know? So I carried that in my path, in this path I chose. I'm a dancer and choreographer and director at the moment, and I've always carried all I've learned from Nestor. He's a very kind soul, no? Very passionate and focused with his work. I remember one time we were rehearsing in a play, and for some reason they weren't able to arrange for the venue. So what we did was to rehearse on the parking lot under the sun with all the people coming and going. And we were just focused on what we were doing. Sabi namin, Nestor, hindi mo nakakaya ito? Sabi niya, no, you just have to focus. So focus din kami, no? And then people were just watching and focus lang, talagang do your work. No? So I learned that from Nestor, and I will treasure that in my heart. I will treasure Nestor. I think the last time I saw him was during a Grand Marian procession when he was part of the delegates for the Our Lady of Kaisasay. No? So I think that was the last time I saw him. He was very open. Like whenever I would ask help from him, Nestor, could you plug naman our show sa viewfinder? Oh, she would readily, you know, write about it. And that's very nice of him. We're going to miss you, Nestor. Happy birthday in heaven. I'm sure you're in heaven's door now. And give my regards to all our friends there. And we'll see you soon. Yeah. Bye, Nestor.
Thank you. Thank you, Raymond.
Thank you, Rose.
Yeah. And now before we call on John Boy for his sharing about especially his last days with Nestor, I would like to call on Nestor's favorite doctor, so I hear. She's a speech pathologist, right? May call on Dr. Carla. Carla Christian Cuadro.
Magandang gabi po sa lahat. Salamat po for inviting me. Siguro po, yung story ko po with Sir Ness is very, very different from all of you. I am not a doctor. I am a speech-language pathologist. And quite frankly, it's a much more fulfilling role in many ways. One of which is that I get to know and be with my patients much more intimately by helping them communicate better again, using their words and use language to express themselves. Help disordered voices to speak and sing again. Rehabilitate one to eat and swallow again. Basically, I help people after a stroke to live. Pero yung mga stories po ninyo, sa totoo lang, and how everyone has fully known Sir Ness are something that I really, really envy, to be very honest. Beautiful stories po. I hang on to every word. I first met Sir Ness last March 2018. He had a stroke the month previous, and I first met him po sa La Verna Aged Care Institute. So even po nung first meeting namin, he was, in my opinion, a wonderful person to be with. Granted, I was assessing his language and communication problems, pero habang nakikinig po ako sa kanya, I asked myself questions and asked him and listened to him during conversations. So I kept on asking myself, how efficiently can Sernes express himself? How can he use his words to tell people what he wants or needs? What can he do? Kung halimbawa na i-stress po siya, trying to look for the words to carry his thoughts across. And is it giving him unnecessary stress? And at that time po, ang pinaka-importanting question was, paano ko matatanggal yung NGP na yan and help him swallow and eat food again? All of you po have known Sir Ness way more than I have. I've never had the good fortune of knowing him before his stroke, only after. But what did strike me was how massive his language storage was in his head. And sure, he had difficulties looking for the usual words, but he almost always had another word to replace what he couldn't retrieve. Tulad po nito, and no other client of mine says it like this. I figured out a particular stratagem to help me with my problems. I focused on my work to an extent that was not necessary in the past. I purposely organized my life na I allow few distractions in my work. I've difficulty accepting the level of work that I can't do in this post. You know, Sir Ness, I dare say, he struggled with his difficulties and it's not easy to have problems with eating. Pero for somebody his stature, mas malaki po yung sacrifice that he bore with the repercussions of fluent aphasia, which is what he had. But in his own way, he never defined himself as somebody that had aphasia, and neither did I. We never believed in labels, especially for him. So, yung aming pong speech-language sessions were directed by him. Siya pa rin ang direktor at happy lang po ako na siya pa rin ang direktor ng aming sessions, especially mga latter ones. He chose what he wanted to talk about, and a lot of it, of course, were his masterpieces, his professors in school, screenplays. He is, in his own way, spoke of his friends and family. He also talked about his mom. And no aphasia could water down how well he expressed how much he loved his mom. So much so, na nung na-hospital po ulit si Sir Ness sa St. Luke's, and his mom was there, grabe po, kinikilig po ako listening to her. Because she mattered so much to Sir Ness, and in my eyes, mommy is such a big star. May share lang po kong one, if I may be allowed to share a picture. Nako, si naka-disable pala yung, okay. I'll try the one and only picture that I have from Sir Ness, because of course, privacy issues. We're not allowed to take pictures of our patients in the center, but at this time we were not in the center. I had very salient memories of him, especially when I tried to look for ways to have him use his communication skills in the social world. Before I knew it, Sir Robert Senya popped by at the Voice and Swallowing Center, followed by Ma'am Isay. Ma'am Boots also came, and we all had lunch in the hospital cafeteria. Kasi po, in my world where I help post-stroke patients talk and eat well again, ito pong setup na ito with Sir Ness and his friends, watch him talk with them and them regale me with his stories. I remember watching everything that was happening and me looking at Sir Ness, and I told myself, I will imprint this scene in my memory forever. So imagine niya lang po ito. Sir Ness was trying to eat his merienda pero hindi po siya makafocus. And his friends were there laughing, full of life, being so expansive with her gestures, being so generous with her smiles, at ease in his company. Sir Ness glowed. He glowed in a way that I have never seen him before. It seemed that he bathed in the joy of being with his family. And it is because of this, of what mattered to Sir Ness, that I made sure I spared no effort in helping him get better in his language therapy. I learned so much more from him than he did from me. And I will have to insist that even if Sir Ness were around and refute me on that. I saw him last po noong March 2020. We were still going through the importance of being earnest. He still came po a few days before the lockdown. And that was the last time I saw him. See po, I love all my patients, whom I regard as my friends. Pero Sir Ness, I loved him differently. So Sir Ness, thank you for giving me a chance to know you. I just wish you were a bit harder to love. But no, you were so easy to love po eh. And I miss you always. Happy birthday po in heaven.
Thank you, Corda. Oh, that's a very different perspective, no? It was very nice of you to share that. Now let's call on our dear John Boy, the only nephew of Nestor. He was supposed to share during the first tribute, but there was some miscommunication. So we'll get his chance. As some of you may know, John Boy also had COVID, no? Around the same time as Nestor or after, before. Anyway, he really went through a lot of challenges, but despite all that, he was there for N.U.T, taking care of him. Really honor you for that, John Boy, and thank you for taking this chance to share with us your remembrance of your uncle.
Hello, Tita Rose. Hello, everyone. Thank you. Thank you for this. Thank you. Thank you very much. So, as you know, kasama ko si Tito since 2006. Kasi naging pasaway ako ng college. So, so I failed some grades and all that. You know, sabi ni Tito, okay, come here. Come here to Manila. So I came to Manila and then sabi niya, okay. So nag-homeschooling muna kami before I went back to college. Imagine. Sabi niya, okay. So English mo. There was a problem there in your English. So let's do that, you know. Write and then, you know, talk in English for, you know, 2 years. At the same time, so Tito is still doing the theater, you know, theater work niya. So, of course, sama din ako. So, sabi ni Tita Cecil, taong ano to eh? Taong bayan, no? Ganun, taong bayan. Chorus, ganun. So, sama din ako. And all that. So, so kaming tatlo ni Uwa, or Lola Isabel, kaming tatlo lagi sa bahay. So, my experience with Tito is, it's like yung sinasabi ng mga nag-share dito na if Tito thinks of something or doing something like that, ganun din nangyayari sa bahay. So if he thinks of something, wanting something to do, we'll have to do it. Parang wala kaming choice. It's just, oh, sige, go with the flow na lang. So one of that is we started praying the rosary. So we pray it every day. Kami sa before we have our dinner, and then it came to a point na even inside the taxi, pag na trip ni Tito to pray the rosary, we prayed the rosary. So it was at first kami ni Uwa were looking at each other kasi parang nahihiya kami, you know, to pray the rosary with, you know, a stranger there. But afterwards we got over it na, no? Like sinabi ni Raymond na, you know, focus na lang, mag-focus ka na lang doon. Diba? Para hindi maano. So, something like that. So, when I hear you're sharing na about Tito doing, you know, thinking of something, doing something to do or do more than usual. So, nangyayari din sa amin yan with Uwa. So, I've heard a lot of yung sharing nyo and in some of those sharing, I was there. So I think I don't have to repeat on that. Ang masasabi ko lang is when I'm with Tito and when he's watching your performances, like si Tita Mitch watching on TV and all that, I always remember na pag si Tito magsalita, maraming sinasabi while watching, it's really bad. Ano, alam mo yun? Yeah, it's not good. So usually, if he's quiet while you're performing, that's good. okay yan. Okay yan. Kasi, ano eh, basta may yellow pad yan ready yan all the time sa pag, pag nanonood siya. No? So, ayun. He likes seeing Tita Mitch, Tita Isay. Basta yung mga, I remember yung kay Alisot, I wanted to share to her nga, I was there when we watched her sa DZ Double B. Ang yung, yung radio, television radio, and we saw her, and then, wow, si Tito sabi niya, she's good. She's good with, being a reporter or a broadcaster. So he wrote about it afterwards, after we watched. So I think Ali really liked that. May approval from Tito yung kanyang, you know, shift to broadcasting. So ayan. So I was with Tito dun sa Santa Ana Hospital. So the first few days he was still conscious na, and then he really wanted to, you know, go home after mag na hospital kami. And then I keep telling him na, yes, we don't have an approval from the doctor yet, but please get well soon para we can celebrate your birthday agad. This, you know, it was, you know, a month, April and then March. So he said, oh yes. So he was really trying his best to fight the COVID. Talagang any test na pinapagawa, si Tito is a bit, kung ayaw niya. But at that time, he really wanted to go home and then, you know, and yeah, be with us. So he really, you know, accepted everything na binigay ng hospital sa kanya to just to get well. And then, yun, yeah, we were there for 11 days. Yeah, 11 days kami. So it came to a point na sometimes he was unconscious and we weren't able to talk to him. And then a few days before he passed, he was declared na coma. You know, they're not expecting him to be conscious anymore. But then, parang two to three days, naging conscious siya ulit. I mean, we were talking again. I was talking and he was, opening his eyes, pointing at me, pointing at, you know, everyone na mano niya. And then, so I was so happy na, sabi ko, oh my God, mukhang ito na yung sinasabi nila mag-recover na. So, it was really hard seeing him nasa bed at the time. And I kept praying. And then, basta masasabi ko lang, he passed na, he didn't have a hard time. When I saw him, he didn't have a hard time. He passed away na, you know, nawala. He didn't suffer at all. So I was thankful na ganun ang nangyari, hindi na nahirapan siya. So, ayun. I love you, Tito, and happy birthday. I really wish na dito ka with us. So, ayun. Thank you, Tita Rose. Thank you. Thank you for having this second tribute so that I can share.
Thank you, John. It's good to know that he did suffer much.
He did. He kept fighting, and then the last moments, it was just very slowly. I wasn't aware nga kasi it was parang tapos na yung pagbabantay ko, I was sleeping, and then when I woke up, parang there was no panic or nothing at all, but just like he quietly just, you know. So yeah. Ganun lang.
Well, happy birthday, Nat. You didn't make it to the 79th, but we're here celebrating with you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you're with mommy, so I guess you got what you wanted. So to close our very special tribute today,
We'd like to call on Andy, very good friend of Nestor.
Ito Andy.
Yeah, our final words from Andy and the beautiful song. So as you may know, one of the musicals that banner musical that Nestor did for us in Mabuhay Rest Stop in Luneta was entitled Manila Vanilla. Yeah, and Andy led the cast with Celine, Fabi with Astarte, Abraham, Naomi Gonzalez, CJ Mangahis, and Edward Fernandez. So we'll end with that. It's beautiful work of Nestor, and who better to end this honoring and tribute than Nestor's good friend, Andy. All the way from Dumaguete, right?
Yes.
Okay, hi, Ant. Good.
Hi. May audio ba ako, Rose?
Yes.
Can I be heard?
Meron,
yeah.
Meron.
Yeah.
Anyway, I hope the other cast members are around. Astarte, Celine, Naomi, Edward. Ah, no, Edward cannot make it because he's somewhere in Mindanao. And CJ, para baka hindi rin makasali. So anyway, we'll be singing the opening song of Manila Vanilla, and it was produced by Rose, and it was performed sa Mabuhay Rest Stop. And during the show, we have a wonderful guitarist in Edward. So wala siya ngayon, so I'll make do with minus one. And this, and we haven't actually sung with this. We haven't rehearsed. And so expect the unexpected. This is City is a Song, and it's composed by Ryan Kayabyab. Music composed by Ryan Kayabyab. Have you ever seen bluer skies or sunlight more brilliant than this, where greens are greener in your eyes and summers never seem to cease? I've been away a bit too long, enough for them to finally know that in this city beats a song that haunts me wherever I go. Manila,
Manila, Manila, I've brought all my suitcases home. How could I have met you when you're all I claim my own?
Manila, 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 finally where I belong. Help
I
it.
Can't help it if I dance to the music in your song.
Astarte, go!
There are too many promised lands where all dreams are said to come true. Four seasons don't make paradise, so I'm coming home to you.
I miss your explosive colors that make the rainbow city alive. It's a town kingdom of mirrors that breathe life through the dark. Manila, Manila.
Suitcases home.
How could I have left you when you're all I claim my own? Manila, Manila, I'm finally where I belong. And I just can't help it if I dance to the music in your song. There are too many promised lands
where all dreams are said to come true. Four seasons don't make paradise, so I am coming home to you.
Your colors that make the rest of the city alive. See the sounds, see the mirrors that ring.
Life, life through the night. Manila, Manila. Manila.
Glad it's over.
Thank you, Astarte. No, I'm sure Nestor would have been mad.
Yeah. I'm sure.
Would love that. And hi.
From the top.
From
the top.
Oh, we just want to thank you.
Direct
Nestor. Thank you so much,
Dan.
Thank you.
Yeah.
A for effort.
Yes. Thank you, everyone. Yeah. So happy birthday, Nestor. Let's sing him happy birthday, Andy.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Sing happy birthday.
Oh, sige.
Okay. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday
to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. And hi, happy birthday, Ness.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Rose. Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rose.
So, take care.
Hi, Andy.
Hi.
Andy.
Rosana, oh.
Miss
nagkita
you.
Nagkita rin tayo ulit.
Okay, oh,
last time tayo nagkita, yung kasama natin, nag-pass on din. Ngayon naman, si Nes naman.
Sa OPM. Oo nga. Hindi ako natuloy-tuloy manood ng Manila Vanilla noon, di ba? How many times
kaya
we planned?
Kaya nga eh.
Lahat okay. Hindi natuloy.
Oh,
nice seeing you.
Nice seeing you too.
Okay. Thank you, Tita Rose, for organizing po. It's been really...
Yeah, thank you, Tita Rose.
Yeah, thank you, Rose.
Thank Hello. You, Rose.
Thank
and
you,
nice
Rose.
Meeting you. Nice meeting all of you. Thank you, Miss Rose, for organizing this. Happy birthday, Direct Mentor. And thank you so much. Rose, can you share the video with us?
Yeah.
Can you share the video with us on Viber?
Okay. Yes, yes.
Thank you. God bless you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Photos.
Bye. Oh, ang tagal na hindi nagkita.
Bye.
Long time.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Hoy, Jojo! Jo!
Hello!
Hi! Hi!
Hello!
Hi! Welcome! Ayan!
Lay! Hi, Lay!
Kumusta kayo?
Hello, Andy!
Hello, Jojo! Jojo!
Ipadala ko na rin ka namin sa Dumaguete ha, pag pwede na mag-travel.
You're always welcome. To my humble abode. To my humble abode.
Nako, ano na yata, asyenda na yan. Yata yan, Andy eh. Mansyon. Mansyon ni Andy.
Parang ano lang to. Parang pangkalapati lang. Kalapati
lang.
Ano
naman yung ganda ng ano, ganda ng mansyon. Diba?
Maraming saging.
Oo, oh, yun, saging marami.
Kaya?
Si Rose na wala na.
Andy, mag-panit ba dyan?
Umalis nila nag-mute.
Oy.
Eh, yung anak ko kasi ready na for school eh.
Ah, ready?
Oo nga pala.
Iba pa lang time sa natin. Oo. Oh, sige, babay na. Babay na. Okay to ha. Babay na.
Bye-bye,
Andy.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
You take care, everyone. You take care, ha?
Take care.
So, come on din. Come on din, ha, John Boy and Jojo and Leia. Yeah. Take care. Oh,
ipadala ko na pictures mo next week.
Okay, okay.
Take care.
Take care.
Bye.
Rose,
God
thank
bless
you.
Everyone.
Bye, everyone.
Bye. Bye. No. God bless you all. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye po.
Bye-bye.